Hello, we're back and we're live for part two of Coming Up on Campus Extrav Edition.
Yes, we are, and there's lots of excitement in the studio this afternoon as we have guests from not one, not two, but six of the colleges.
Indeed, they're here to give us the lowdown on all of their extravs as tickets go on sale tomorrow at 11 a.m.
So get ready, get excited, extravs are just around the corner. Hi, I'm Claire.
And I'm Jess, and we'll be talking you through everything you need to know about extravs.
As they approach, the big question on everyone's mind is, which ones do I want to go to? Well, we'll hopefully be making that decision a little bit easier with the help of some guests.
With the themes released just last Saturday, we thought it would be helpful to get direct information from all the colleges. And what better way to do that than get them here in the studio?
Yes, we'll be talking to six of the colleges as they give us inside information on each of their events.
We'll also be getting our fancy dress and fashion correspondent to give us the do's and don'ts of making your own costumes, as well as her best tips for dressing up.
And I'll be here backstage with the rest of the extrav committees, and we'll be talking about what the other colleges think about the other colleges' extravs. And if you want to listen to us and tweet in, then hashtag CUOC.
But the most important thing to remember is that tickets go on sale tomorrow. From 11 till 2, you can buy tickets to your own college's event, and from 2 o'clock onwards, all extrav tickets go on sale.
This will all be going on online, so put it in your diary, put an alarm on, a reminder, anything. Just make sure you remember before they all sell out.
Tickets do have a habit of getting sold out very quickly. Last year, the quickest selling extravs sold out only in a matter of minutes.
As everyone knows, the themes have been released for almost a week now, and here are George Robinson and Sajan Patel from Filed to tell us about their Noah's Ark strap.
My feet can't touch the ground, and it feels nice. I can see the sands on the horizon at time. You are not around, I'm slowly drifting.
So guys, what made you choose Noah's Ark Strav?
Well, we think that it's a good theme, really, just because it allows people to dress up with whatever they want to do.
Yeah.
I mean, when I went to extravs last year, the main reason why I went was because of the theme. It was so good, and it allowed me and Saj to dress up, you know, in what we wanted. Like, we went for the aliens, because that was Toy Story.
Okay.
And it was just a massive part of it, really.
How did you come up with the actual thing, Noah's Ark? I mean,
Noah's Ark?
It's not a generic theme, is it?
No, so. Well, obviously the movie was a big thing. We've got a long history of going for movies, so we wanted to kind of like keep that in the loop. But also, animals, you know, there's so many things, but we thought, because obviously Grisdale had animals last year, we couldn't go for animals, so we thought if we go for the Noah's Ark, it just allows anything, you know, you can go as Noah, you can go as a rainbow, you can go as it's not just animals, even go as Morgan Freeman if you want. It's not a massive
and I suppose you could go as a group as well.
Yeah, exactly, you can, exactly. And obviously in pairs, which is the main part.
Yeah, because it's always fun to dress up with your friends, isn't it? It's
nice
way of
doing
it. Moving on to music. Mm-hmm. What kind of artists do you have going?
Well, we got a range. We decided to go for acts that are from Lancaster and outside, as well as DJs and bands. So we'll probably start with the Marties and BC555, and then go on to DJs like Simba, Corky and Jay Matthews. We've got someone called Jasto coming from Sheffield. And
so you've got quite a long list.
Yeah,
we've got
Fleur.
We've got a video of one of your guests here coming up.
Yeah, sure.
Bring her in?
Well, mainly because we obviously Corky and Simba and obviously Martins and BC555, they're well known in Lancaster, but we wanted to get someone outside of Lancaster to make it a bit of difference.
That's quite a big deal.
Exactly, it's kind of like a bit of both worlds.
Yeah.
And also, the reason is because we kind of wanted more vocals rather than a DJ set. Obviously, we've got DJs past, you know, half 12, but I think there's something about a vocalist who provides like crowd interaction, and it'd just be, you know, a good time.
Bring a bit more to it, doesn't
I mean,
it?
She did. She's toured with DJ Fresh, and she has played at V Fest, and you know, she's done covers with Rudimental and all that.
Oh,
so
wow, that'd be really good.
Fun.
Yeah. So how did you go about getting into contact with her? And
well, we just well, I asked the Shug House DJ. Really, so.
It's
my contact.
Well, you've got to what you can, because it's not necessarily easy, is it, to get people on? And all the extras kind of fight over who
exactly.
they can get on.
Well, we were in contact with quite a few people, but I think that chose to be the best option in the end, so.
Yeah, it'd be great.
And what else will there be to look forward to on the night, would you say?
Well, we've got food, so we're going to have burgers done by Uni Catering. We've got a range of acts. We've got quite a lot planned, but you'll have to come.
We've also got an inflatable gladiator ring as well.
Oh, exciting.
So, just have a few competitions on that.
Yeah.
And free ice cream as well.
Ooh, lovely.
And also some nice decorations as well, and some surprise on the night.
Sounds good. So, how do you expect people to dress up as it's...
The main aspect is probably come in pairs, you know, when you go on the art, you come in pairs, but I'm really hoping that people don't just dress up as animals, but they also dress up as the other aspects of the story, you know, to do with like...
No, you can get creative, you can even try and dress up as an arc, I guess.
I mean, it is a good one because you can either be really basic in what you wear, or you can go all the way.
Yeah, exactly. We're hoping to expect quite a few onesies there as well. That's always a good sight.
I have a cat onesie.
You can use it. How have we got two though? For your hair.
Yeah,
so.
That's true.
Lancaster.
I've got a reindeer, but not a cat, sorry.
I think we're talking about going as Noah, I think.
Oh, that's exciting. Both of you?
Well, I can go as Noah and he can be my wife, obviously.
Right, well, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Cheers. And next up, we've got John from Pendle's Prehistoric Extrav.
Turn the music off! We need to get out!
What? Oh, shit!
Right, hello prehistoric Pendle. It's a bit different. Can you tell us how and why you chose a theme?
Well, we wanted to go for a theme which was not necessarily done in recent years because extra themes can be a bit difficult to be original.
Yeah.
So we're trying to think outside the box of something which you could dress for accordingly but also arrange efficiently. So we thought something prehistoric would do the trick.
Both, yeah.
So your promo teaser leading up to the release seemed to throw a lot of people off track. Can you tell us what was going on there?
Well, in the leading up to an Extrav release, there's obviously a lot of people on JCR who know exactly what the theme is.
Yeah.
And obviously people on JCR have their own friends, their own friendship groups, and we wanted to avoid the little fragments of society knowing exactly what our theme was purely because who their friends were. Throughout there being Miley Extrav or Miley Strav, just to try and throw people off and think, what's actually going on in Pendle? So then when the actual Extrav leaf came out, there were more...
Did people within the JCR know that it was going to be prehistoric, or had you kind of not
no,
even
No, people in JCR
about...
knew exactly what the theme was. So we were just trying to hide it from the general society, really, because... As I say, extra themes can be leaked very easily.
Yeah, I mean,
and we just wanted to throw everyone
guessing.
Off.
Yeah, it was good. And who have you got lined up?
Lined up, we have. I have a little list with me.
Oh, there we go.
Pendle Extrav is very heavily band based, so we've got bands such as Kasoma headlining, and we got my favourite runner up, The Fighting Keegans, Yellowbird, BC555, and then. A few more campus-based bands on top of them. And then DJ-wise, we have a set from DJ Christy, Josh and George. And then to finish the show, we have Neil Jackson.
Okay, so quite a few people as well.
Yeah, we have a fair few raps.
You should have written it on the stone. So that
I would have.
I have to comment on your attire. Is that what you'll be wearing?
This may not be what I'm wearing. Hopefully, I shall be getting different attire. But I thought... For the interview-wise, I'd get myself a little costume ready. This hair wig is very frustrating.
Now you know how we feel.
Yeah, exactly. You'll end up eating most of it. It's going everywhere.
It's going everywhere.
Yeah.
But you know what? Why not make the effort?
It's all fun.
Why
isn't
not? Could you tell us anything that you think people may need to know about your Extrav?
May need to know about our Extrav? There's going to be a lot of prehistoric decorations-wise.
Yeah.
Obviously, drink seals will be frequent for our Extravs. Pendle Extrav is... It's not confined so much, but it's out in our quad. So be prepared to be in and around everybody. There's not much space to sort of be by yourself.
Yeah.
So... it's very... not very confined,
no, but...
When you're out and you've got the massive stage in front of you and there's nowhere you can be besides being in front of the stage.
That's a nice kind of area to have, isn't it?
Yeah.
Going on more of a dress-up kind of thing, I mean, I wasn't completely sure because there are talks of T-Rex Drav, so I was thinking, is it a dinosaur? But now I see that it's more...
Yeah,
it...
obviously, we try to advertise it as Prehistoric Pendle presents T-Rex Drav, but
yeah.
The theme itself is prehistoric Pendle.
Okay.
T-Rexdrive was purely a play on words, so okay. It wasn't prehistoric Pendle events, yeah. An extrav.
Yeah.
But no, the official theme is prehistoric Pendle.
So is it more like a kind of Flintstone style?
Yeah, like? Flintstone, the Croods, volcanoes, Street. Fossils, cavemen, fair. Cavewomen. I mean, if you want to make the effort to come as a dinosaur, I mean,
yeah.
Why not? I mean, it's May more well. Than welcome. It'll be fantastic to see people in dinosaur costumes. But no, the official theme is prehistoric Pendle, so anything you consider to be prehistoric,
okay.
Really.
Well, thank you very much for coming in.
Oh, that's fine.
And best of luck with your extrav.
And both Filed and Pendle are on Tuesday the 24th of June. The first of the extravs. It'll be difficult to choose between the two.
Cartmel are also on the Tuesday night, however, they couldn't make it here today. Here's a sneak peek at their promo anyway.
We're really sorry, but Cartmel couldn't be here. But what did you think of Pendle and Fylde's extra?
I think it was great. I think it was great they came up in costume as well.
Yeah.
What would you dress up as, do you think?
A dinosaur.
Yeah, it would have to be a T-Rex all the way.
How would you do that?
Green.
would you get scales as well and just stick
yeah,
them on?
Yeah, that kind of thing. I think so.
So do you think Fleur is like the best part of Fylde's extrav, or what do you think?
It's a big part of it, definitely. Yeah. It's a good act to get, especially for an extrav.
Yeah. Everyone knows who she is, so it's good. Yeah. Very good.
And what about you guys? What do you think over here?
Yeah, I think it's a great act. I'd love to know how they got a hold of her. I'm really looking forward to Fylde's. I've got my gorilla onesie ready.
And here's over here with Furness, and what do you think of Pendle?
I like it. Yeah, it's good. Very original. I think it surprised a few people last year.
Yeah.
Were they going to change? Did they change it last minute?
Pendle.
I think it was Fylde.
Fylde definitely did.
Yeah. It was cheeky, but surprised us all.
Yeah.
Sure.
Good name as well. Yeah. Yeah. Archives a great name.
Yeah. Don't know what I've done on that one.
Yeah, but that's us, and back to the studio now.
We now have Boland and their Big Top Circus.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, step right up, step right up. Come closer, you won't believe your eyes behind this curtain.
The big man of Boland, and you're here with Anthony. How are you both today?
Doing well, yeah.
Yeah? And now, circus. What should we be expecting from this?
we've got a lot lined up. I mean, we've got societies, we've got some fantastic acts, we've got Anthony here as a magician who performed on the night, but we're going to go bigger decorations as well. We're going to try and simulate a circus top, which will be cool if we pull that off.
That's exciting. And circus is a bold one in recreating the atmosphere and the whole scenery of it. How do you plan on going about that?
Well, yeah, going back to sort of having like some, trying to simulate a circus top, actually like trying to do that. And also like the acts, having them sort of going around. We'll have some circus style treats like food as well. So.
Oh yeah, that's also good. Really good. And I mean, costumes have to be really colourful for this. Have you planned your outfit yet?
Well, I have to be really boring on the night and wear my JCR top, so...
Oh no, that's a shame. You've not got like a clown wig or something?
Just trying to stay away from clowns.
Okay. And what will you be wearing?
So, unfortunately, working, yeah. Basically something similar to this.
Okay,
saying, yeah.
That's exciting. Will you be getting some of your magic tricks out?
On the night, yeah. A lot of them. Branching into mentalism now, so you'll see a lot without cards, which is quite good.
Ooh, yeah, because we've heard here that you're somewhat of a magician.
Somewhat.
Have you got any tricks for us?
Yeah, one I like to call pressure, actually.
Yeah.
Which I can just borrow Lee's phone.
Yeah.
It's just as simple as getting a balloon, any random balloon, and a phone.
Yeah.
Placing the balloon into the phone.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
There we go.
Well, that's great, thank you. And yeah, I mean, is that what you'll be doing? You'll be going around all night?
Yeah, most of the night at least. Just performing to random groups. And anyone who wants to just see a trick, just feel free to come up to me and ask.
Okay, yeah. And because how long have you been doing it? What?
On and off about 5 years now. Started just at the start of college, so yeah.
Okay.
Quite a long time.
Mm. When did you learn that trick?
That one, 2 weeks ago.
Oh, of course. Yeah. How do you do it? Do you go on YouTube?
And... Well, that one, I saw another magician do it, and I came up with another way, which is at the end of it, you just simply go. And then the phone's out.
It's good. It's a good little trick.
Yeah. Thank you.
Will you be taking cards around? And
yeah.
That kind of thing?
Cards, balloons. I've got a very good trick with my phone, which is someone can send me a text, and I can read the text before I open it. But that's all to do with reading the people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, it really sounds like a brilliant one. I mean, thanks for joining us here today, guys. And now we have County and their Cancun Spring Break. Joined here by Anna and Ebony from County College. Girls, could you tell us about your theme?
Well, it's Spring Break Cancun. It's basically we're bringing Cancun to County. That's the whole point. The sun, well, it probably won't be sunny, but hopefully. Yeah.
The biggest party destination in the world, Cancun, we're hoping to bring that to County. So that's the vibe we're going down.
Something a bit different, bit cool, but yeah.
Okay, that sounds great. I mean, is that to do with the whole summer coming up theme? Is it getting people excited?
Yeah, getting people hyped for summer, because everyone loves summer, so we just
Even though it's spring break, we wanted to bring like more of the party edge to Extrav rather than the
just
whole...
Just the theme.
So like you want to bring like it to make it the biggest party on campus.
We want it to be like an experience rather than people be so hooked on a theme, do you know what I mean? Like, oh, it's this theme. We want to make some, actually have, like we're at university, it's all about partying, we want a good... night, a good experience.
So you're a hyping party,
yeah,
rather than just focusing on what am I wearing kind
yeah.
of thing.
Yeah.
We can go down different routes with fancy dress because it's Cancun as well. We took the Mexico way.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
So it's not just spring break. We've gone down quite a Mexican route as well, so you can dress up like Mexican, like...
It's very open. Like people might think, oh,
that's
it's just
why,
a bikini.
Yeah.
But actually, in Cancun, at night, there's big nightclubs. Like, you can literally dress as if, like, you know, when you go to Zante or
yeah.
anything like that, and you wear just shorts and t-shirt, you could literally wear what you like.
But
like,
we're hoping a few
yeah.
Mexican routes to
okay.
go down with the theme.
Yeah, because at the beginning, when you see the promos, sometimes you think, well, is it just bikini? But
yeah,
that does kind of...
You. Yeah.
Extend it.
I mean, just more like summery
practice.
Holiday, you know. Like, I'm probably going to wear just like a dress.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, it's not bikini.
I'm going as a cactus.
How are you planning to do that?
I have no idea.
Are you going to make it yourself?
Maybe.
And I mean, other themes require like face paint and that kind of thing, but here are we substituting the face paint for fake tan maybe to get a summer glow?
No, definitely not. We're thinking of going down like UV paint as well on
okay.
the door.
Paint
yeah.
as well.
We're having
That's
temporary tattoos on the night, aren't we? So,
yeah, and we're going to have literally glow in the dark everything. So,
oh,
like when
exciting.
It goes dark, like we're having footsteps over paint, and you can do it, you know,
yeah.
we're going to have tons of paint. That UV and glow in the dark, so you can literally do what you want.
So like maybe like the festival theme, like rave, like paint as
yeah.
well, face paint. So we're definitely
really.
Up for the face paint. You can fake tan if you like. But.
Yeah, it's all really exciting
yeah,
to be honest.
Yeah, yeah. And what sort of music do you think you'll be playing?
We've got Sound Slaves and Anton Aiden,
mm-hmm.
and we've got a couple of uni DJs as well. So it's more
okay.
like house. It sounds cliche, but club. Do you know what I mean? That
yeah.
kind of like
going down the DJ route.
Yeah, yeah, no bands.
Like
got
dance
all DJs.
Music,
yeah.
all that kind of thing.
So
that you'd
yeah.
expect
things that you can dance to. Yeah,
from like big party type thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, is there anything else you'd like to say about it regarding?
Just well, basically, we've kind of obviously quite a few colleges are focused on music. We've focused more on giving you guys a really good night, so we've gone for more freebies. We're getting so much free stuff, so like we're just lots of free
yeah.
stuff, so it should be really good. We've got the surf
massive,
simulator
yeah. Massive water guns are going around.
Yeah,
oh,
huge.
That's
water.
Exciting.
Going to the surf simulator will be really good.
With a photo booth.
So,
and then we're getting projections as well, put up all across the county where behind the stage. We're getting bubbles, like confetti cannons,
yeah.
streamers. Just
wow.
Do you know when you're just in the audience and you're dancing, so
we want to make
there's
it really
gonna be
like,
loads
perfect.
Going on.
Exciting,
yeah.
yeah. Going all out.
And
yeah.
hopefully everyone will be like
yeah.
vigorously partying.
I hope so. I just want everyone to have a good
oh.
a good night, because obviously people might say themes cliche or whatever, but we just want everyone to have
yeah.
a good time, which
oh no, it sounds great.
Be.
Let's hope
yeah.
the weather's good.
Yeah, fingers crossed. God.
Well, it really does sound really, really good. So, and it should give people their first taste of summer, really.
I hope so. I'm excited for it.
Yeah,
yeah. Getting us excited as well. Next, we have James and Steph from Grisdale.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
Thank you.
So guys, what can we expect from the music at your event?
Lots of variety. We've got singer, bands, DJs, including Shane Patrick, which should be great. We didn't want to just focus on one main element, we wanted to give everybody something that they'd want. So yeah, lots of variety.
Will it be following along the lines of the theme, or will it be just an overall kind of
there will be periods that it follows the theme, but generally it's wide variety.
I know, like, we've also got like a guy playing from the college, so we're kind of keeping to our college a bit, and he said that he's done themed specific songs, so
that's good.
Yes, yeah, that should be really good.
It's going to be a surprise though as to what. We'll wait and see whether it's
good. So food, that's something we all love after a few drinks. Will there be any creativity over the food?
I'm aware that all the other colleges have pretty much the same thing, but ours isn't. Ours is from a different supplier. So ours are actually, well, apparently the gourmet burgers, and also things like sausage baguettes, double chips, all the usual. It should be really good. We've got a very big supplier. It's a big bus, so yeah.
Because people will be getting very drunk, so they'll be eating a lot.
Oh yeah.
I know I would be.
And, I mean, what a theme, space. Like, it definitely sounds good, but how are you planning to decorate? Is it going to be like a futuristic-based thing, or is it more of just within space?
I'd say futuristic, so.
Okay.
I take it. We've been quite lucky. We've managed to pull quite a lot off. I mean, I think everybody was really impressed with our decorations to go along with our artists.
I think also like the fact that it's like space rave. We've got quite a lot of like neon glow in the dark,
like
bright colours.
Attach the two together.
Yeah.
And it just fits so well with the bar.
Yeah.
We have the best bar.
I can imagine actually. It'll work quite nicely. Are you going to have those little flying saucer suites?
That's a good idea. I get onto that quickly.
So personally, I don't own a space suit. What would you suggest I wore if I went?
There's all sorts of things.
It depends, isn't it? Do you want to go like hardcore, like fancy dress, or do you just want kind of like easy to get, grab on, throw on?
Like hardcore fancy dress.
Yeah, I've heard all sorts of things. There's like people are gonna make like paper mache planets and like climb inside them. And then there's gonna be like spacemen, stormtroopers, kind of just.
And there's always it isn't just space, it's a space rave. So, you know, there's rave gear is always the classic go to, just in case, you know, you are running a bit.
Yeah, because upon first thought you kind of think astronaut. But once you think further into outside the box, it's true, there's quite a lot. Do you know what you two will be going as, or not yet?
Well, we have to generally wear our polos so that we're visible from a health safety
point of view. Oh, that's true, I keep forgetting.
Yeah, but I mean, we will be doing something like Alien Ears or something on those lines. It'll be quite fun.
And finally, why do you think your extra will be the best?
I think we've managed to pull off something that perhaps the others haven't, in terms of what we've managed to do with the limited budget we have. I think it could be really.
Is it the effect of the place? Would you say like a wow effect?
I mean, the decorations I think will be amazing. Again, Shane Patrick should be really good.
Yeah.
We're really looking forward to having him.
How long have you been planning?
Yeah.
Just out of curiosity.
Before Christmas.
Yeah. Oh really?
Yeah. A long time.
Yeah. Sounds like a lot's been going into this one.
Yeah. Anyway, thanks for coming in, guys.
Thank you for having us.
And that rounds it up for Wednesday's extravs.
Okay, so we've got some tweets now, and BC55 said he wants Charles L. Calvert to do a crowd surf for Extrav. Josh said it's County all the way.
Woo!
And there's loads of things. The Martys are really excited about the Fard and Grisdale Extravs. And so what do you think about the Bowland, Grisdale and County's Extrav?
Well, I think County's got a very popular theme beach party. Never going to say no to that. I think Bowland, it's quite an original theme, like circus.
Yeah.
Very, lots of costume opportunities for that. And Grisdale, obviously space. I've always wanted to be an astronaut, so it's a great opportunity for me.
Yeah.
Do all of you go really like hardcore with your costumes, or do you try to do it as cheap as possible?
Yeah, just simple, whatever I can find in my cupboard.
Yeah.
Okay, so how would you do the cheapest possible thing for making an astronaut costume?
Tinfoil tissue everywhere. Tinfoil. Fridge box. cardboard box from a fridge and just tin foil. Or silver spray paint.
And a fishbowl.
Yeah, fishbowl.
It might suffocate,
yeah.
But, you know.
It's too big for a fishbowl.
Okay, so back over to County now. So what do you think about the Grisdale and Bowling being on the same night?
Yeah, I really want to go to Grisdale.
We wanted to go to Grisdale, yeah.
About that.
And circus.
Yeah.
What would you dress up for circus?
I don't know. I think I'd go as a
clown.
I'd go as that man that tames the lion.
Oh, that'd be cool.
With a whip and everything.
With a whip?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, a little bit cheeky, yeah. But okay. So, if you went as a clown, would you go really creepy or like funny?
No, I wouldn't go creepy. I'd go droopy clown, because I've got droopy lips. It's a sad clown.
And how about you guys? What do you think of Pendle as well being on the same night?
I think it's a really good theme. I really like it. Although, I think there's a reason why dinosaurs are extinct. they couldn't fit on the ark.
Okay. Back over to Grisdale. So, what do you prefer? Yours, Bowland or County?
Oh, it's hard.
We have to go with ours because we put so much into it. Definitely.
Not because it's the best theme.
If you had to choose, so between Bowland and County,
choose wisely.
I mean, they're right next to you, but.
Cool.
Hi, James.
I think County to me.
Yay!
Oh, yeah, Bowland. I'd say County as well, because I went Bowland last year. So.
Yeah, we
just
did.
Just a bit of variety.
And we think our day's, look, it's just such competition is really strong for our day. No offence, guys.
So really, you're just being fair, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so how did you feel about that, the choosing
right.
County over you? What is that?
People make mistakes.
Okay, we're coming for a game next, and we're going to try doing a bit of costumes. So, who wants to go first? Get out their pens and creative ideas.
Okay.
Wait, let me get your pen.
That's too easy, you're going to have a top hat. It's too easy. We'll change it up then.
Don't do
a top hat.
You can't do a top hat now.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Or a flower wig.
You have to do some hair as well, remember?
I've got an idea.
What is a joke? There might be some eyes in there somewhere that might be an idea.
Yeah.
The
well, as you
terrifying.
Can see, Pendle has already done this because they had to leave early. And
what's
it's sort of like a beard with a massive nose. So
is he smoking a cigarette?
Take from that what you will.
Is it
or is the nose the cigarette?
It's a lion!
What is it?
Is
it's
it
a
cigarette? I thought
it's
it was
like
just
hair.
Hair.
Is it a lion?
It just looks like your hair.
It looks a lot like hair.
It's me. I'll be a bald next round.
Okay, let's try. Let's see who can go next. Let's do feet filed. Come on.
Really?
On your knees, George.
Okay, so Fars extra theme. Go on, why don't you tell us what it is?
Yeah.
Did you forget?
No, if you're watching the show, it's Noah's Ark strap.
Okay, so what do you think we could do?
Flippers.
Just put some water around.
You could go like duck feet
or
like
flippers
a beast.
Or sandals.
Yeah.
Or
you have to go like crow feet or something.
Boots. Wellington, surely.
Wellington.
Big
oh, yeah.
Blood.
Need you. Okay, can I like extend it a little bit?
I guess
wow.
Go to that here.
Yeah, because we don't need much for the legs.
So
For the people doing like torso and legs and stuff, you can be male or female. So.
We'll get some droplets on there, show it there.
There's no such thing as gender.
I know, this is
okay, so
as John James before.
Yes, they're wellies.
Okay.
Impressive.
You can tell we've got going to have really good decorations at Firewood with that sort of yeah.
I'm not the creative director. So
oh, okay. So that's okay. Grisdale, do you want to go next?
I think we're all quite a difficult one.
Well, if you think like space and stuff, then.
I'm gonna go for space man, space pack.
You gotta get the rave aspect in there somewhere.
Space rave.
Loads of buttons. How would you do that in your life, do you think?
That's
would you buy it or would you make it yourself?
Cardboard?
Yeah, cardboard.
Spray
like
paint.
Bottle tops and stuff. Let's draw a little fly because they're in space.
Went into furnaces.
No, you didn't.
No, it's okay, we'll have the right hand. We'll have the right hand.
The right hand will be nearly.
That is the right hand.
The left hand. The hand on the right.
The left hand's where the magic happens.
Okay. That looks really cool. I mean, he doesn't have a suit on, just the pack, but it's fine.
For no budget.
This isn't real.
No budget.
All realism at all level, we are half a lion, half a cave. Okay. Come on, Bruce.
Okay, come on, come on, Ryan. You have
to
do fairness proud.
It's got to be a sword or a lightsaber.
Yeah, or a joystick.
Joystick.
He's got the Jedi sleeves.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
thanks, guys. I do geography. I don't need to go. That's more of a club, but.
You're not doing well here.
It's a
lightsaber.
Now it looks a bit like
maybe
something
make it
else. I found where the magic happens, Will.
Lightsaber.
We all know what's on Ray's mind.
Alright, well. I think that's a lightsaber.
It's definitely a lightsaber.
Okay, it's definitely a lightsaber.
It's a hairy one.
Okay. Bolin, why don't you go next? But just before you go, Anthony, do you want to show us a magic trick, maybe? Okay.
Show us a magic trick.
I use just these three.
Okay.
Easy to keep up with. Right, so, three cards. So, the first one reads this. The second one also reads this.
Okay.
And the third one reads that, yeah?
Yeah.
So, if that's on top, yeah? And I take that and put that to the bottom. Where's that?
Okay, I'm getting really confused already. So,
well, that's
the bottom.
Okay. Is it?
That's
this. So maybe I left it on top. Maybe I cheated, but that's this. Yeah.
Okay.
And if that's this and that's this, then that must be that. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So that's this. That's this. And that's this. Yeah. If that's this, then that must be that. Yeah. So that's that. So that's that. Yeah. So if that's that and that's that, then that's that as well. Yeah. But if that's that and that's this, then that must be this and that must be this. Yeah.
Yeah.
But if that's this and that's that, yeah, then this must be another one.
Whoa!
Oh.
That's pretty awesome.
Oh my god.
Woo. Wow. Okay, so we're going to see more of that at Boland.
Yeah.
Okay, do you want to try doing your costume?
They've already done it.
Oh, sorry.
Counting.
Do you
want to
try again?
Oh!
Okay, so back to county then. Sorry about that. I just
apologize.
Had to say it. I just
don't
had to say it.
Nice one.
Keep it tight and short.
Oh.
Oh, come on.
Is that your
motto or something?
Mosquitoes.
Okay.
Oh my God,
that's what you'll be getting at county if you go. Okay, we have to get back to the studio now. But this has been fun. And
that drawing was really great. It's now time to talk about Thursday.
And that is Furness, When Worlds Collide. We'll be right back. Hi, Ryan and Will.
Hello.
Hi.
First of all, your theme is very unique. Could you explain it a bit for us?
Well, there's actually four separate themes that we're going to split up into the different spaces in Fairhurst College. So we've got sci-fi, which is sort of things like Doctor Who and Star Trek, stuff like that. Star Wars also. Then the world of gaming, so like Mario Kart, Pikachu, Pokemon, things like that. And then superheroes, the comic book heroes, really strong genre. And then finally we've got fantasy, which includes Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings and the Hunger Games.
How are you going to split that up? Is it going to be by area then?
Yeah, exactly. Like, so we've got four quite distinct different spaces within the furnace area that we're going to use, and each of those different spaces will encapsulate the theme.
Just curious, because I didn't go last year. Where will it
Shocking.
Be? Will it... Well, I didn't go to any, so unfortunately. Will it be in that square outside your bar? Or
that will be where the stage is, so where the main performance area, and then the different rooms will have the different themes in, so
people
can chill out and have a bit of drink and stuff.
Where did the idea come from? Because it's quite...
It was the process of a long toss-up between several different themes, and we eventually just decided, you know what, we can just do all of these and make it one theme.
Yeah, because it's not a common one. I mean, I haven't heard of it before, so it's... quite a new
it's
one.
It's entirely original.
Yeah.
I can't say it was my personal idea, but I'd like to think that I had something to do with it.
It kind of just came out of part of a really long group conversation, really. And it just
We were originally going for, I think, heroes and villains.
Yeah.
We were kind of focusing on that idea, and obviously that encapsulates a very broad thing. So we thought we should kind of semi-define it to give people an idea of what costumes to wear. You're right there.
Just chill.
You're enjoying Clifford.
That's kind of where the four worlds, four themes came up. So,
what do you visualise in terms of the design? Like, how will it look?
The extrav.
I'll be telling.
We'll obviously put up plenty of decorations. But we can't give too much away.
Yeah,
we've got a few tricks up our sleeve.
Plans.
But they'll be very distinct. The different spaces. They'll be very.
Okay.
It's going to be good. It's going to be good atmosphere.
I'm excited.
How long have you been planning it?
Since January.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
We got straight on it. Yeah.
Literally week one we were thinking, right.
Extra.
Yeah.
And you've gone through what people can wear. Do you know anyone that's already been planning what they're wearing?
I know somebody is going as, what's the princess called from Frozen?
Oh, Elsa.
Princess Elsa.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I know a group of guys that they always, there's like 14 of them, they always come as a specific group, and they're coming from as Game of Thrones characters.
Oh, that's
cool.
Good. That's really, really good. So like with Frozen, can you actually go into, I didn't think cartoons and that kind of thing would feature in it.
I think that would come
fantasy.
Under fantasy, yeah.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah.
So that'd be quite popular. Frozen would be very popular.
I think,
I assume so.
We'll see.
It's a great film.
Yeah.
And you guys can't dress up then? That's
just
what we're hearing.
We can dress up a little bit, I think.
Yeah.
I know a few people on the JCR who are planning to dress up, but obviously we have to wear our polo tops. I think we can dress up around them.
You could do like headgear.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Trousers.
Well, thank you ever so much for joining us.
Thanks for having
no
us.
Problem.
And that rounds it up with a very intriguing theme for Thursday the 26th.
Okay, so we've got some tweets here now. And Chris says he's a bit worried about where Clifford was in the last segment with Will. And Switch Magic says that they know what to expect at County Extrav with tight and short. And BC55 says fair play to the magic guy, and we all like that. And thanks to all the guests today. We had fun having you on. And that's that. And back to the studio.
Once again, we'd like to give a big thank you to all of the guests that made it here today.
For the colleges who did, we will make sure to film their extrav. This will be done in a Sugar TV style, as we'll be making a show for each of them.
Yes, it will be very exciting, and after having spoken to them all, I'm convinced that they will all be great.
One of the most exciting things about extravs is the dressing up. So some of the themes sound like they'll need a lot of work on costume, which makes it all the more exciting.
Here is some old extrav footage to show you what we mean about the costumes.
legend of the phoenix, all ends with beginnings. What keeps the planet spinning? The force from the beginning.
As we're no experts at it, we thought we might invite someone who is, so we're now joined by Rachel. Now, we've heard some wonderful things about your handiwork, but first, I've got to ask, I've heard about tonight, you're going to, is it a musical party? Yes. What's happening with that? Because I've heard about some of your costume ideas.
Well, most of the way now, through a Rum Tum Tugger costume from the musical Cats. One minor hot glue gun injury so far, but hopefully that'll be the last
glue.
Of it.
Hot gun glue? You're going all the way.
Other than that, it's going quite well. I'm going as Anna from Frozen, match the hair colour to the costume.
Yeah. So how's that going? Have you made the dress yourself, or how...?
Yeah, I have it down here.
And for Rum Tum Tugger, I heard you started pulling wool out? Brushing wool out, or...?
Yeah, because the way they make wool with twisted strands, so if you untwist those strands, it's kind of more hair-like.
Like cat hair, type
Yeah, so you can get a better dress.
That's a dress.
Yeah, which I made during my exams as a sort of procrastination attempt.
You made this?
That's lovely.
Wow.
It's just a ribbon.
And it really works.
The skirt is a circle skirt, is it? So if you hold it up, it's just a circle with a great big hole in it. Oh. So any costume, you need a skirt. Just cut a big hole in a piece of... in a circle.
It's good tip.
And then you can wear that as a skirt.
How long did that take you, would you say?
About a day, but spread over about 3 weeks. So
not too long. Is that a tail?
This is a tail.
Oh.
It's just about 15 minutes. You strip a fabric, sew along one side, stuff it, loop on, so you can wear a belt, attach it through your belt, and you've got a tail.
Oh, that's nice.
So you can theme it, whatever animal you want, has a tail.
Yeah, tiger.
And if anyone at home has any questions for Rachel, don't forget to hashtag CUOC on Twitter or send us a message at our Facebook page, LA1TV.
And we've been told about some of your past fancy dress costumes for Extrav. Could you tell us what they were?
I've been Jessie from Toy Story, that was filed last year.
Do I see a hat?
Yeah, I have a hat.
There we go. Glittery hat.
I have cow prickles. This is what happens to Sharpie when you put it through the washing machine.
Oh,
it gets up quite pale. And I have a shirt which I embroidered.
Okay.
To match hers.
And your hair matches as well, Jeff.
I've tried to keep with the ginger theme with all my costumes. I've been Ginny Weasley again with the ginger theme. I can't remember.
We were going to move on to this year's extras, but before we do, can you tell us the best place to get costumes in town or around Lancaster?
If you want them pre-made, on Covent Garden Street, on top of the pet shop, you go into the pet shop and up the stairs, and that's the fancy dress shop in town. If you want to make it yourself, Wilko's is a pretty good place to start for basics, coloured bin bags and wool and things. Or there's Fabrics, which is near Sainsbury's, where you can buy all sorts of wonderful fabrics, furry and otherwise.
Okay. I'm sure there are loads of other shops as well that are around. I mean, they're just dotted around, I think, aren't they?
Yeah. Google is your friend.
And what would you say are your best tips for people making them at home? Like, just anything that you've had to learn out of experience of doing it wrong?
Don't underestimate how much time you need. You'll probably need longer than you think you do.
Really?
And the earlier you start, it's a bit more fun. Get someone else involved, because that's always more fun. If you can get a friend in to go as a pair and help each other with costumes, it's a bit more social evening of it.
And then moving back now to this year's extras. So starting with Noah's Ark. It sounds really interesting. I mean, what would you be tempted to do with this theme? Because you can play around with it quite a lot. So how would you go about it?
It would depend, I guess, if you're in a group of friends. If you're an even number, you can go in pairs, and that's fine. If you're an odd number, maybe you'd have some animals and a Noah, or some animals that made it on and one that didn't, like a unicorn. So two horses and a unicorn. It wouldn't matter then if you didn't
have a pair. I suppose you could wear this for now.
Yeah, you could any animal tail, put a tail, put a peacock's tail here.
If you were to go, what would you be tempted to go as?
I quite enjoy my peacock costume.
Can you just hold it up?
Can't really, it's a bit.
How does it go on? Is it around?
It's got ribbon that ties around your waist. Yeah.
Aww. That's nice.
Or you can have the nice jellyfish with a sort of clear umbrella with sort of bubble wrap attachment.
Oh, that's
a
good
jellyfish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Wear your
wellies. The Lancaster well.
Yeah.
So how about pendles? Have you ever given the prehistoric theme a go before?
I haven't, no, but there's lots of ways you could do it. If you went sort of cave person, you could wear any clothes that you've got, old clothes, if you cut them up a little bit. Or dinosaur, you wear a hoodie. If you sew sort of white felt triangles around the top, you can be a mouth. Spikes down the back of your hoodie. And you'd also be warm if you go outside.
And moving on then to Boland, it's a bit of a funny one, because you can either keep it really simple or go all out for it. I mean, where do you think the creativity lies, really? I mean, what would you
The thing
do
with circuses is there's so much. You could go Cirque du Soleil, sort of acrobatics, gymnastic stuff. You could go old-fashioned clowns and lions and ringmasters. Circuses these days are so varied that whatever you want to do, you'll be able to fit it in somehow. Even if you're just coming in vibrant colours.
Yeah, and I can imagine that, you can even bring animals into it once again, anything of that sort.
Yeah. And so finesses, that seems to be your expertise, really. Surely you could go as you are already, or some as the other costumes.
You know how you've already done the Anna costume?
Yeah.
So you could actually just go straight away.
Just on that, yeah. It's quite an interesting one. There's so many things you pick. Whatever, I'd be tempted by something from Game of Thrones if I had a bit more time for the sewing.
That'd be difficult though, because it's difficult to make it look like it's actually Game of Thrones without people being a bit confused as to what it is.
Yeah, you'd have to have props, I guess.
Yeah.
Maybe a head, lots of heads rolling around.
I mean, already for this animal, I've heard that you've got the knee socks, have you, going on?
The boot covers, so that I'd have to ruin a pair of boots. Wear a pair of socks, cut a hole in the bottom to put your high heel through, and then you can paint them, you can decorate them, any costume you want. Sci-fi ones particularly often have like thigh-high boots. You can match them to your costume with just really long socks. Yeah.
And you're even putting, I've heard, the white streak in your hair, is it?
Yeah, and it's also UV, it's UV hairspray.
Oh.
So it'll hopefully look white and light up in the end of the back.
And County's theme really sits apart from the others, I'd say, because it's kind of a different dress.
Yeah, County's one where you could probably find whatever you want to wear in what you already own. So swimsuits, denim shorts, flip-flops, and you're ready to go.
Summery.
Yeah,
it's quite an easy one if people don't really fancy dressing up, I guess.
And finally, Grisdale's was one where you have to go all the way out. How would you go about dressing up for that one?
The thing with this is it's space rave, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you could think astronaut with colours, UV astronauts. I imagine there will be a lot of cardboard boxes at that one.
Yeah, that's true.
Cut out cardboard. bits of X cartons glued on for buttons and dials and things.
Those things, they're just things that I don't seem to think about without someone telling me, to be honest, but you seem to come up with it just like that. And just to finish off, can you give us some of your do's and don'ts of making fancy dress?
Do have fun with it. Don't get yourself stressed by making something that you can't do or that you don't have time to do or something that's just crazily elaborate. If you're not having fun, then you might as well not even be going to Extrav.
Yeah.
Do also be careful with glue guns, needles, anything sharp or hot.
Can I ask what you were using the glue gun for?
It's for a wig.
Oh.
We're gluing fake hair onto a wig.
How's that coming along?
Not great.
No?
We've done about a third of it and
How do you, what do you rest it on? Because surely it
we started resting on, it was on a football, but the heat from the glue gun popped the football.
Oh.
So it's now on a bowl, upside down, mixing bowl.
And that works, it doesn't...
It's not melted yet, so fingers crossed.
And thank you for coming in on the show. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you very much for having me.
Okay, so now we're going to go see what's happening backstage. Okay, so we've got our sound engineer here, Josh. How are you, Josh?
I'm okay.
Has it been a stressful day?
It's been very stressful, but we're nearly done.
Well, you seem like you were having a little bit of fun in the last 2 minutes with your baby hand that you ripped off.
It wasn't me, it was
maliciously.
It was Luke.
Okay, and if you come over here, then we've got our producer, Ben.
Hello.
Do you want to say anything about the show? Did you like it? I mean, I know it's not over yet, but...
Quite well. Quite stressful, but yeah, it went quite well. Quite well.
And we've got director Luke.
Hello. How's it going? I can hear myself, so I'm going to cue myself to finish.
Okay, and if you come back here, then you've got Ben and Chris. How are you guys back
I'm
here?
Not bad. You might notice I look absolutely filthy. It's because I was actually trying on the cat costume that Rachel's talking about is for me for tonight, including the half-made wig, and I'm covered in bits of hair for ready for tonight.
Well, she did just say that the wig wasn't going well, so
it's taking
good luck.
Start at 8, so we really need to wrap this show up so I can go home and finish it.
Okay, well, I'll stop then and I'll leave you. Thanks for everything and back to the studio now.
And we leave you now with Extrav's Insight and Summer already here.
We will be back with more coming up on campus throughout the term, so make sure to look out for it. I'm Claire.
And I'm Jess. Thank you for watching. Bye.
Goodbye.